plus 5 and minus 5 using all possible representation. Represent plus 5 and minus 5 using all possible representation. So, when it comes to representation, we are having two broad categories: unsigned number representation and signed number representations. So, again, here it is three categories. One is sign magnitude number representation, one is complement representation, two is complement representation. So let me write in this way so that the whatever the points I have written in the beginning, those all things can be compared at the one place. So if I want to represent plus 5, right, I already told there is no sign bit concept we are using in this form, in unsigned form. It means by default the number is positive and we don't have to think even the plus sign. Whatever the binary equivalent of 5, directly write that. That means what we did so far, those are the unsigned number representation only. So directly the answer is 101. Don't put any 0 anything else because we are not using sign bit concept. When it comes to minus 5, it is not valid, put across. This is because already I told, this is not valid for the negative numbers. When it comes to sign magnitude number representation, so the plus 5, what we'll do is, with respect to 5, what is the binary equivalent of this? 101. With respect to plus, we'll have a 0. So this is this, whatever I've written, this 1-0 combination, that with respect to this 5, and with respect to this plus, we're having the 0. As already I'm telling you, that the positive number representation in all the three forms will be same. The same logic to be followed here and the same logic to be followed here. So, plus 5 representation in all the three forms is same. Whereas if you come to minus 5, the representation is different. So, what we will do in the sign magnitude form, you have to remember this as a procedure, that's all. So, if I am interested to represent minus 5 in sign magnitude form, so you take the 5, so this is 101 in the binary form. With respect to negative sign, put a 1. So this is pretty much straightforward, easy. Take the 5, represent that 101. If plus is there, put a 0. If minus is there, put a 1. So this is the logic magnitude number. Whereas if I'm coming to one's complement form, that the logic is not same here, and that logic is not same here. So if I want to represent the minus 5 here, so if I want to represent minus 5 in one's complement form, so what I'll do is this equal to 1's complement of plus 5. So minus 5 is equal to 1's complement of plus 5. So I can write this equal to 1's complement of what is plus 5? Plus 5 is 0101. So what is 1's complement of this? This equal to 1010. So the 1's complement representation of minus 5 is 1010. Similarly, coming to this, so this is also similar to this, but what we'll do is this is 2's complement of plus 5, which is equal to 2s complement of 0101, which equal to, what is the 2s complement of this? 1101, right? So this is what the answer. I hope this is clear. Plus 5 representation all the three forms is same, sign magnitude 1s as well as in 2s. Whereas if it comes to minus 5, it is something else in sign magnitude, something else in 1s complement, something else in 2s complement. So, I can summarize this, that if I am interested in plus 5, so it is having three possibilities. So, what are those? This is 0101, 0101, 0101. Whereas minus 5, it fits. So, this value is 1101 in the sign magnitude form, this one. And its value is 1010 in 1s complement form, its value is 1011 in the 2s complement form. So you can see the plus 5 having unique representation in all the three forms, minus 5 having three different representations in three different forms, right? So suppose, if someone is asking me a question in the reverse way, suppose someone is asking, a signed number, listen carefully, a signed number is given as 1101, then what is the decimal equivalent of this in the reverse way. Now what we did is, number is given in decimal form, we represent that in its binary equivalent. But now we want this in the reverse form, that is, the number will be given, this is in the binary form it is given, signed number 1101, then what is its binary, what is its decimal equivalent. So when it mentioned this signed number, see here, nothing to be confused actually, here this is signed number, under signed number there is a category, subcategory, signed magnitude representation, right. So nothing to confuse, signed magnitude is a subcategory under signed number. Signed number, if I say, it represents three forms, this, this as well as this. So when I am saying signed number, it indicates these three forms. And if I am asking, this is the question, what the decimal equivalent of signed number, it is an ambiguous question, I can say, my question is not complete. Because it is clear that this digit, because it, the MSC bit is 1, it is a negative number. If it is negative number, I have to mention that it is in which form, because the coding logic is different, because to represent minus 5, we use some logic here, that logic is different here, and that logic different here. Because the coding logic is different, definitely the decoding logic has to be different, right? So we cannot say what is the answer of this. But of course, if I am saying this is represented in sign magnitude form, or it represents 1s complement form, or in 2s complement form, like this if I am saying, of course then we can find what is the answer of this, right? So we will do that, how to do this in the reverse way. So but this is what the observation we should do here. So what I told, that is same. 1 point, plus 5 represents all three forms is same, minus 5 represents any different. But the point is, in the positive representation, sign bit is 0. In the negative representation, the sign bit is 1. In all the three forms, sign bit is 1 in negative form and it is 0 in the positive forms. So this is what, how do you represent this? So there are many questions. Based on this logic, we will solve that. But let us go in the reverse way now. I will say, this is in the this form, this then this form obtain the decimal equivalent. Let us take the examples to illustrate this. The question is, obtain the decimal equivalents of following. Obtain the decimal equivalent of the following. First question, unsigned number 1011 and 0110. Second question, signed magnitude number 110 and 010. Third question, 1s complement number 01101, 2s complement number 01101, sign magnitude number 01101. This is question number C, means, okay, you can take question number C, D, E. Then the next question is, this side I am writing, 1s complement number, let us say F, 1s complement number 1101, G is 2s complement number, let us take the same number, 1101, H is sign magnitude number 1101, I is signed number 1101. So we are having these questions. Let us try to find this. So I hope you are getting what I am doing. We are going the reverse way. What we did now is, I have given a number plus 5 by minus 5 in decimal form. So I asked to find what is the binary equivalent of that. So by doing that, we are avoiding that negative sign. But I am going the reverse way. Already, a coded number is given to you. A number has been coded in sign magnitude 1s or 2s form. Right? That means the sign has been absorbed. Whether it is plus or minus, that is not given. The sign is not given. But we have to interpret whether what it is, whether it is positive, negative, if it is what is the magnitude, like this. We have to find the opposite way. Right? So let us proceed how to do that. We have seen that how do you code a number in unsigned form. I told there is no sign bit concept. It is straightforward conversion. So directly I can say 1011 corresponds to 11, of course plus 11, right? And 0110 corresponds to 6. Nothing to be confused. We should not think that this represents negative, this represents positive. Not like that. I told clearly, sign bit concept is not valid for unsigned number representation. So it is straightforward. This is 11, this is 6, right? But when it comes to sign magnitude number, I hope you remembered how to do that. So what I did in that case is, in sign magnitude number representation, so I told, suppose you want to plus 5, write the binary equivalent of 5. If it is plus, put a 0. If it is minus, put a 1. So the same logic. Because it is sign magnitude number, sign bit concept has been used. With respect to MSV, it is confirmed that it is a negative number because it is the 1. So with respect to this one, I am taking negative here. And with respect to this 1, 0, I am taking 2 here. So this is minus 2. Whereas coming to this, with respect to 0, I will have plus. With respect to 1, 0, I will have 2. So this is minus 2, this is plus 2. If I am coming to next, 1s complement number, I told clearly the positive number representation in sign magnitude form, 1s complement form and 2s complement form is same. That means what I did in this case is I have replaced the 0 by plus, right? And whatever is there, I am finding the magnitude of that, provided the number is positive. So you see that in the C, D and E, these three bits, the sign bit is 0 here, the sign bit is 0 here, sign bit is 0 here, right? And that to be, because the number is same, I told that positive number representation in all the three forms is same. So directly I can say the answer for this with respect to 0, I will have plus, right? With respect to 1101, I will have 13. So this also will be plus 13, this also will be also plus 13. No doubt on this. Because positive number representation in all three forms are same, because these three are the same number, so answer has to be same. So these are the simple things. But we should be a bit careful in those four bits. That's why I have represented this in a separate way. So whenever it comes to 1s complement number, right? So it is given the number has been already coded. We need to find that. So what we'll do here is, you remember this as a procedure only. So what you do, so with respect to this one, take a negative sign. With respect to this one, you take a negative sign. Then write a statement here. Decimal equivalent of 1s complement of that number. What is the number? 1101. So this is equal to, again I am putting it is, so decimal equivalent of 1s complement, this is how much? 0010. But what is the decimal equivalent of 0010? This is 2 only. And along with that, I have a negative sign. So I have to write the answer as minus 2. So only you remember this step, this statement you have to remember. Actually, there are two methods. This is one method. So let me complete. I'll give the second method also. So coming to this one, so I can say exactly same, but in place of 1s complement, I have to write 2s complement. So remember this as a procedure only. For positive number, it is straightforward. But when it comes to negative number, we have to remember these steps. Right? So here, this is, you, because this is 1, again you take a negative sign, then decimal equivalent of 2s complement, in place of 1s, I am changing this to 2s complement of the same number, 1101. So this equal to, negative is as it is, decimal equivalent of, what are the 2s complement of this? This is 1, this is 1, this is 0, this is 0. So if I am finding the decimal equivalent of this is 3, along with that I have a negative sign, so the answer is minus 3 here. Right? But if I am coming to sign magnitude number, it is again see that this again comes under this category only, right? So with respect to this 1, so I will have the negative sign. With respect to this, I will have 5. So the answer is minus 5 for this. So to go in the reverse way, there is no confusion, nothing else with respect to positive numbers. So it is same. Negative number also no confusion, but you have to remember these steps. For sign magnitude, it is pretty much straightforward. But for 1s and 2s, you have to remember the first statement. Then you can easily do that. And if the last question, what is the signed number if I am asking, see here, that if I am asking signed number, it is an ambiguous question. Because, you see, for illustration purpose, I have taken the same number here. F, G and H from these three, what is the observation we should make? If I am giving a signed number 1101, that this 1101 having three possibility. This represent minus 2 in 1s complement form, right? So, this represent minus 2 in 1s complement form, this one. This represent minus 3 in the 2s complement form. And this represent minus 5 in the sign magnitude form. So, unless until quoted clearly that is it in the sign magnitude or 1s or 2s, I cannot say specifically what is the answer. Because that depends that in which form it is given. It is very clear to you, right? So, if it is given, we have to specify which form, otherwise it is an ambiguous question. So, signed number means there is no answer for this. It is an ambiguous question. So, I hope this is clear. So, positive number is straightforward. And for negative number also for sign magnitude, this is, you have to remember in the same way. Like replacing 1 by negative and remaining thing find the straight decimal equivalent. But when it comes to 1s complement or 2s complement, you have to remember the statement. But I am telling you, there is one more method or one more formula is there to calculate this. If you don't want to remember this statement, there is one more method is there. In books, there are various things are given. So, what is that method? That is only valid for this and this only, right? So, let us see what is that. So, what you do, suppose 1101 is there. So, let me rewrite the F bit. So, 1101. So, the first bit, you take this is minus 2 power n minus 1. Means, n value is 0, n value is 1, n value is 2, n value is 3. So, minus 2 power 3 minus 1 plus remaining things will be as it is like the normal binary conversion plus 2 square into 1 plus 2 power 1 into 0 plus 2 power 0 into 1. If you solve this, how much you will get from this minus 8 minus 1 minus 9 plus 4 plus 2. So, 2 plus 4 is 6. 6, I did any mistake? 6 minus 9 is 3, 2, 4. This is 1, right? This is 1. This 1 is here actually, sorry. This 1 is here. So, this is minus 2 power 2 is minus 4 plus 4. Just a minute. This is in the 1s complete form, right? So, it is minus 2 power n minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 2 power 3. Okay, sorry. Let me write it once again. So, I can say this is, with respect to this, you take this is minus 2 power 3 minus 1, right, into 1 plus 1 into 2 square. Plus 0 plus this is 1 into 2 power 0. So, how much you are going to get with respect to this is this is 2 actually, so minus 9 plus 4 minus 5 plus 1. Okay, we'll see this later. Okay, so you take this as the this. So, there is some formula is also there, but it is always convenient to go in this way. There is also one formula, I will tell that in the next class. So, this is what the way we solve these kind of problems. So, let us take another set of problems, and let us make some important conclusion based on this. So two things I will tell. The one problem in the beginning, I have taken some wrong data, that one I will rectify, and here a formula is available because I am acquainted with this method, so I always follow this method, so it simply is skipped out from my mind. I will refer and I will tell in the next class what is the formula, but there is no difference whether you go by formula or you go by methods, both are same, the answer will be same. I will tell in the next class how is it. Now let us see the next one important observation let us do. The following numbers, are represented in 1s complement form. Obtain their decimal equivalent. The following numbers are represented in 1s complement form. Obtain the decimal equivalent. The first one is 0101. Next one is 00101. Let's take the second one, 1101. 111 01 111 101, right? So let us find what is that. Already you have solved this model, but let us go in this way, that let us once again find this. So this and this, these are the positive numbers, and I told that if you observe the sign B, it is 0, it is a positive number, so I can say the answer of this one is how much. With respect to 0 we have plus, then the decimal equivalent, this is equal to how much? Plus 5. So here also you see that with respect to 0, this is plus, and with respect to 0101, this is 5. Now you see that it doesn't matter how many number of 0 I put in the LSB side, always the answer what I am going to get is plus 5 only. There is no doubt on this. Because what I am saying is I am going to generalize the statement from this, that's why I am saying this way. Now come to this. So how do you find this, the answer for this one? With respect to 1, this is negative. Because in 1s complement form, we have to write the statement, decimal equivalent of 1s complement of 1101. So this equal to negative of, this is decimal equivalent of 1s complement of, this is minus 0010. So this corresponds to answer is minus 2. Similarly, if I am finding for this, so with respect to this is MSB is 1, so I'll have again a negative sign, again I'm writing the statement, decimal equivalent of 1s complement of this entire number 111 01, this is equal to negative of decimal equivalent of, this is how much, 1s complement of this, replacing 0 by 1, 1 by 0, so 000, this is 10, so this answer is again minus 2. If I am doing for this, again the same logic, here I will have one more 1 and here I will have one more 0. So it means once again the answer what I am going to get is minus 2. In other words, you see, I can give a statement here, I will write the statement first, listen carefully. It doesn't matter whether the number is positive or whether the number is negative. If we copy the sign bit any number of time towards left, there is no change in the original value of the number. What I want to say, that even if I am putting 100 number of zeros here, the value is plus 5, plus 5, plus 5. Similarly, if you observe this C, D and E, what I did here, what the sign bit here? The sign bit is 1. This sign bit has been copied one time here. The sign bit has been copied two time here. So whatever the sign bit is there, if I am extending this any number of time towards left, all the case in these three cases, I am going to get the answer minus 2. Because if I am going by this method, because it doesn't matter whether I put here 10 more 1 or 100 number of 1, all the cases in the second step I am going to get is 0000. So definitely the answer will be minus 2. Whether I take 2, 2, 1, 3, 1, 100 ones, doesn't matter. So I can generalize the statement. In the 1s complement form representation, it doesn't matter whether the number is positive or the number is negative. If we copy the sign bit any number of time towards left, there is no change in the original value of the number. I'll generalize the statement. Let me repeat this question for the 2s complement form also, and let us try to see what the change you are going to get. So now you modify this question, repeat the above question for 2s complement form, or I can say here, if the following numbers are represented in 2s complement form instead of 1s, obtain their decimal equivalent. So of course, for the first 2 bit A and B, because positive number represents all 3 forms are same, there is no confusion, it will be plus 5 only, but there will be change on this. What the change I have to introduce here? Decimal equivalent of 2s complement of this. So decimal equivalent of 2s complement, what is the 2s complement of this? So here I have to do the change. So this is 1, this is 1, this is 0, this is 0. So this corresponds to minus 3. In a similar way, if I am considering this one, this is with respect to this one, I have the negative sign, then decimal equivalent of 2s complement. Why I am writing 2s? Because this is given the 2s complement form. And again, it is the same logic here. So what is the change I am going to get here is that if I am finding this with respect to 1, I will have 1. With respect to this 0, I will have 1. Remaining all are zeros only. So if I am finding this, this is minus 3. Once again, I am repeating for these things. So once again, the answer is minus 3. There is no doubt on this. So whatever the observation we did for 1s complement form, the same observation is equally valid for the 2s complement form as well. So we can say, it doesn't matter whether the number is positive or negative. It doesn't matter whether the number is represented in 1s complement form or in 2s complement form. If we copy the sign bit any number of times towards left, there is no change in the original value of the number. This statement is very important, and what I was saying, many questions are coming from this based on this concept only. You wait for some time, I will solve some problems so that you will get the idea. So let me write down the statement. What is the observation? It does not matter whether the number is positive or negative, whether the number is positive or negative, whether it is in 1s or in 2s complement form. If we copy the sign bit, if we copy the sign bit any number of times towards left, there is no change in the original value of the number, right? Most of the question from this chapter are based on this statement only. Mostly we are focusing on 2s form, but that is also valid for 1s form. It doesn't matter whether the number is positive or negative, whether it is 1s or 2s complement form, whether it is represented in 1s or 2s complement form actually. If we copy the sign bit n number of times towards left, there is no change in the original value of the number. So this is what important conclusion we are drawing from these examples. I hope this is clear. What I am saying, that wherever the sign bit is 1 here, I copied this 1 time, copied 2 time, copied 3 time, even if I copied 100 times, all the case answer will be minus 2, minus 2, minus 2 if it is in 1s complement form. All the case answer is minus 3, minus 3, minus 3 if it is in the 2s complement form. So taking this as the fact, let us solve one problem of instrumentation. Gate 2006 instrumentation problem. So what they asked is, the statement was given like this. A number is represented in 4 bit 2s complement form. 2s complement form. As x3, x2, x1, x0. If it is copied, into a 16 bit register, which of the following represents the correct value of the register, correct value of the number? Right, options are given: 0, 0, x3, x2, x1, x0, 1, 1, x3, x2, x1, x0, x3, 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 x2, x1, x0, x3, x2, x3, x2, x1, x0. So this is instrumentation 2006 gate problems. Right? I hope you can easily say the answer. A number is represented in 4 bit 2s complement form as x3, x2, x1, x0. If it is copied into a 6 bit register, which of the following represents the correct value of the number? It means what has been done here is a number was there, right? The bit size was x3, x2, x1, x0. Now this has been copied into a 6 bit register. So if it is copied into 6 bit register, we don't want to change the value of the number. The only thing we want that the bit size of the number should be increased from 4 to 6. If this is the case, which of the following represents the correct answer? So of course we can see from this observation, the answer is C, right? Because the sign bit is how much here? Sign bit is x3 only. So we have to increase the size, means we have to copy the sign bit to our left. So that x3 has been copied 2 times here, right? So this is the answer. I cannot say A is the answer because I don't know whether x3 value is 0 or 1. If it is known to me that x3 value is 0 or the number is positive, this is the answer. If it is known to me that x3 value is 1 or it is negative number, this is the answer. For generality, because nothing is mentioned, so we have to give the answer in the variable form. So this is the answer. And this cannot be answered anyway, right? So answer is option C. So see, from this observation, this question has been framed. This is known as sign bit extension concept, which is used to increase the bit size of the number. Actually, in certain microprocessor, in certain operation, it is needed that the bit size of the number has to be increased from one particular value to another values. That is the string length. So in such kind of case, simply we have to copy these things. Okay, so this is what one question they asked. Another question we got, you see, let us solve that. You see, 2009, the following numbers, are in 2s complement form. As 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0 1, then their corresponding decimal equivalents are then their corresponding decimal equivalent or option A 57.25.9, option B minus 57 minus 25 minus 9, option C minus 6 minus 6 minus 6 minus 7 minus 7 minus 7. Get 2009 EC problem. The following numbers are in 2s component form, then their corresponding decimal equivalents are. See, just by observation only, we can eliminate some options here. See, if I am taking this number 1001, if I am compare this number with this and this, what is the change? This one has been copied one time here. This one has been copied two times, three times here. Is it not? One has been copied one time here. One has been copied three times here. That means, with respect to this number, the sign bit has been extended. It is meaning that, because it is given in 2s complement form, so whatever the decimal equivalent I will get with respect to this, I will get the same answer with respect to this, as well as the same answer with respect to this. Right? So, that to be, because the 2s complement form, and this is what? Negative numbers, because the sign bit is 1. This is eliminated, it cannot be positive answer. And we also know the answer for these three is same, so this is also eliminated. It cannot be different answer. So either the answer is minus 6 or the answer is minus 7. So to get that, take any of this and find this. 1001 is there. So it is in 2s complement form. Take this with a, because it's a negative number. So remember the statement. With respect to 1, I have taken the negative 1. Then decimal equivalent of 2s complement of 1001. This is equal to negative of decimal equivalent of 1110, right? 2s complement. So this bit as it is, after this I am interchanging this. So this equal to minus 7. Even if I take the next one, so if this is one more one is there, here I'll have one more 0. Once again the answer is minus 7. Even if I take for this, even I put 10 more 1 here, so 10 more 0 I have to put here, once again the answer is minus 7 here. Definitely the answer is minus 7, minus 7 and minus 7. Right? So this is also one more question they asked from this. It is EC 2009 gate problem. Once again they asked EC 2001, 2s complement representation is given like this. A number is represented in 2s complement form. In 2s complement form, inside bracket, one sign bit and 15 magnitude bit. It is given like this, inside bracket, is F F F F base 16. Then its magnitude in decimal form is, then its magnitude in decimal form is option A 65,536, 32,764, 10,000, option D is 1. These were the questions they have asked. A number is represented in 2s complement form, FFFF, right? So I can say this number is 16 number of ones are there, 16 number of ones. Because if I am converting this into binary form, I will have 16 number of ones, like this, because to, for a shorthand notation they have used this, but this is not the thing actually. So this is in the 2s complement form. So we need the magnitude of this in its decimal form. It is very much clear, because the sign bit is 1, we'll have a negative sign with respect to this, then decimal equivalent of 2s complement of, right, this entire number. So 1 1 1, like this all 1s, right? So this is equal to decimal equivalent of, if I am taking the 2s complement of this, so with respect to the first one, I'll have 1, remaining all, I'll have 15 number of zeros will be there. So if I'm finding this, what is the answer here? The answer is minus 1. But minus 1 is not an option. But it is asking magnitude. Magnitude means we have to take the mod of this, right? So the answer is plus 1. Magnitude means we have to take the mod. So this is also, you see that the same model. I think 2 years back, in one of the DRDO paper, they have what they did, the same thing, and here they have given like this. The number is appended in 2s complement form as follows. Like this, they have put it, and up to minus infinity they have written like this. So what they have given is, a number is appended in 2s complement form as follows, and that as follows is this one. Then what is the decimal equivalent of this? But the answer then here, the answer will be minus 1, is it not? Because it doesn't matter how many times you repeat here, even if infinite time, the answer will be same. So see, the same concept, how many different ways they are asking the same question. So this is one of the important observation we did. Let us see one more important observation in CS as well as in EC, that question has been asked. So let us see that. So what is that question is? Obtain the decimal equivalent of following. Obtain the decimal equivalent of following. Question number A is sign magnitude number zero 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 and 1000. Question number B, 1s complement number 0000 and 1111, right? Let us see this, and we will make a nice observation from this also, right? So how do you solve this problem? Sign magnitude number means it is pretty much straightforward. You know that how to do that. So because sign bit is 0, I told how to decode these kind of things. So here we have plus, with respect to this we'll have 0, whereas coming to this, with respect to 1, I'll have negative sign. With respect to this 30, I'll have 0 here. So 40 represent plus 0, 1000 represents minus 0. Similarly, with respect to this, positive number representation in all the three forms is same. So this is plus 0, no doubt on this. And this is the 1s complement form. With respect to 1, I am taking a negative sign. Again, write the statement, decimal equivalent of 1s complement of 1111. So this is equal to decimal equivalent of, what is the 1s complement of this? 4 number of zeros. So this is equal to minus 0. So you see here that even if 0 is a single number, practically we do not have any concept of plus 0 and minus 0, right? We never say the answer is plus 0, minus 0. It is simply 0 only, right? But even if 0 is a unique number, the sign magnitude representation as well as the 1s complement representation treats 0 in two different ways. One is plus 0 separately, one is minus 0 separately. But this is not the case with the 2S complement representation, and that is the main one of the most important reason that for why in most of the practical purpose, if you take any microprocessor or any digital device to represent the negative numbers, 2S complement method is used. This is one reason, and after some time I'll also tell one more reason why is it so. Right. Now, in other words, we can go also in the reverse way. It means, if I'm saying to represent plus 0 and minus 0 in two different ways, in sine magnitude form, I can say this is 0, 0, 0, 0. Right. And with respect to this, I can say this is 1, 0, 0, 0. Right. So, with respect to sine magnitude. With respect to 1s complement form, again, the logic is same. But with respect to this minus 0, what I have to take? I have to take 1s complement of this. So, this is 1, 1, 1, 1. If I am asking the same thing, like represent plus 0 and minus 0 in 2s complement form, the answer will be same. So let me write down the question. What I am asking is, represent plus 0 and minus 0 using 2s complement form. So how much you will get? With respect to this, I will have 0, 0, 0, 0. Let us say I am using 4 bit. With respect to this, minus 0, how to do that? If you remember, to represent minus 5, what we did? In that case, we have taken the 2s complement of plus 5. So, if I am taking 2s complement of these 4 zeros, once again the answer will be 0, 0, 0, 0. It means the representation of plus 0 and minus 0 in 2s complement form is same. We do not have separate plus 0 concept and minus 0 concepts. Whereas, if you come to this, plus 0 is separate as well as minus 0 is separate, right? So, this is what one of the important observation. So, the question that came in one of the previous CS paper is in which of the following numbers we are having two different representation of 0, right? And of course, that was a wrong question they have given in that gate in that year, because they have given option both sine magnitude as well as 1s. It is not correct. 0 having unique representation in 2s complement form, it is having two different representation in sine magnitude as well as in the 1s complement form. So, this is what one of the important conclusion. Now, one more question they are asking, a formula based question, that is range of numbers. Range of numbers. But before we do that, let me make one more observation, then I'll give the this concept range of number. The question is, represent, question number 1 is this, minus 2, minus 4, minus 8, minus 16, etc. or minus 2 power n in this format using 2s complement form. Question number 2, if the following numbers are in 2s complement form, obtain the decimal equivalent. So, to represent minus 2, so first of all I should represent what is plus 2. So, plus 2 representation is 0, 1, 0. So, minus 2 representation is 2s complement of this, because I want 2s complement form representation. So, answer is 0, 1, 1. Similarly, for minus 4, what I should do? First of all, I should represent plus 4. So, that is 0, 1, 0, 0. So, if I want minus 4, this will be 0, 0, 1, 1. Right. Similarly, for minus 8, so first of all, I should represent plus 8, which is 0, 1, triple 0. Minus 8 means 2s complement of this, means 1, 1, triple 0. You can observe a pattern here that if I am representing minus 2, minus 4, minus 16, minus 32, all these numbers which are in minus 2 power n form, it is following a pattern. What is the pattern here? The pattern is, see, Suppose minus 8. So this corresponds to, I can say, minus 2 power 3. So you can see that is double 1 followed by n number of zeros. So suppose minus 8 is minus 2 power 3. So double 1 followed by 3 number of zeros. So double 1 followed by 2 number of 0. Double 1 followed by 1 0. So directly I can say, if I want to append minus 16, so I can say the answer is double 1 followed by 2 power 4 means 4 number of zeros. So this is what the answer we are getting in this. Then coming to second question, if the following numbers are in 2s complement form, obtain the decimal equivalent. So let us say the numbers are given like this. Suppose 10, second one is 100, third one is 1000, let us say 15 number of zeros, 4 number of zeros. So these are in 2s complement form, then how do you find the decimal equivalent of this? Once again, remember the same statement. So what I have to do in this case, with respect to 1, it is a negative number. Then decimal equivalent of 2s complement of 10. So decimal equivalent of 2s complement of this. What is the 2s complement of 10? It is again 10. So answer is minus 2. Similar way, here also like this, but I have 100. So if I am finding that what is the decimal equivalent of this, the answer is minus 4. The answer is minus 8. The answer is minus 16. Now you compare the result of question number 1 and the question number 2. What you are observing is, if I am going in the straightforward way to represent minus 2, the representation is 110, right? But if I am decoding the 10, I am again getting the minus 2. For minus 4, if I am going in this way, the answer is 1100. But here, it is what? 100, because minus 4 represented this. Minus 8 means 1 followed by 3 number of 0, but here double 1 followed by 3 number of zeros. Of course, already because from the sine bit extension concept, it doesn't matter how many number of 1 I put, so that doesn't change the original value of number. So the point to observe that if a number is coming in minus 2 power n format, the minimum number of bits that needed to represent that is nothing but 1 followed by n number of zeros. Right, 1 followed by n number of 0. I want to say that minus 8 here, we have represented this 11000 here. Minus 8 is 11000. So this is we are getting by this way, but by going reverse way, this we are getting. But already we know that by sine bit extension concept, this and this both are same. Right? But what is the difference? The difference is, this is the minimal representation. I need minimum number of bits. So to represent this minus 8, I need 4 bits. But by going in this way, I need what? 5 bits. So you can generalize the things that to represent a number which is in minus 2 power n form using 2s complement form, the minimum number of bit we need is equal to n plus 1. I want to say that minus 8 is nothing but equal to minus 2 power 3. So the minimum number of bit I need is 3 plus 1 equal to 4. For this, minus 16, how many bit I need? 5. So this comes only on this format if it is minus 2 power n form. So you take this as one observation. Based on this, let me give you range of numbers. We are getting question from that, a formula base, and we'll close the session for today. So I take down the heading, range of numbers using n bits. So first one is sine magnitude number case, 1s number case, 1s form. Second one is in the 2s form, right? So what is the maximum positive number? What is the maximum negative number? So that is what we want to see. So if n is the number of bits, small n is the number of bits, then using this form, it is minus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1 to plus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. 1s complement also same, minus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1 minus 1 to plus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. Whereas coming to 2s complement form, it is minus 2 power n minus 1 to plus 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. I mean to say that if I take n equal to 4, if I am substituting here, so the range of number that I can represent is minus 7 to plus 7. The range of number I can represent is, again same, it is minus 7 to plus 7. The range of number I can represent is minus 8 to plus 7. So if I am taking a numerical value of n, I am getting these other things. By comparing these, what is the one important point you can observe? That if I am using n number of bits towards positive side, these three are same. You see, these three are same. But when I am talking regarding negative case, these two are same, sine magnitude of 1s, but this is something else. That is, I am in a position to represent minus 8, the negative extreme is minus 8 in 2s case, but the negative extreme is minus 7 in 1s as well as in the sine magnitude case. In other words, we are in a position to represent one extra negative number in case of 2s complement compared to the 1s as well as in the sine magnitude. Right. What is the reason for that? The reason for that is that in 2s complement form, the 0 having a unique representation, whereas in 1s complement as well as sine magnitude have, they have two combinations. So here, if I am expanding this, if I am writing this, I will have minus 7, minus 6 like this, minus 1, then I will have minus 0, then plus 0, then 1, 2, like this up to 7. That is what the case with this also. But whereas coming to here, minus 8, minus 7 like this, minus 1, then 0, then 1, 2 like this up to 7. So here whatever is minus 0, plus 0 concept in 1s and is a sine magnitude. So that is only 0 in case of 2s. That is the reason in these two forms that 0 is occupying two places. But here because of unique representation, we are in a position to represent what? Means one extra number. And already I told you that minus 8 we can represent as 1 followed by 3 number of zeros. So this is a very important conclusion that a 0 having unique representation in 2s, but it is having two representation in sine magnitude and this. And this question has been repeatedly they are asking in various competitives. So one way to remember this result, that in sine magnitude as well as 1s, these two extremes will be same with opposite sign. But whereas in 2s, the negative extreme will be 1 greater than the positive extreme. Right. So this is what the discussion regarding today's fine. Let us take a break and we'll continue the session. that is the reason. But the major advantage is this, the technical reason is this, that we are saving one extra bit, one negative number. So, which textbook should I follow for this subject right now? It is Tossi book. In the last session, I told the book name, you can refer that. Mani is asking, sir, how to identify how many bit belong to sign bit when we expand number of bits? By default, the MSB1 is the, see, it is very clear, right? You know, 1s complement as well as 2s complement, there is no ambiguity. But when I am dealing with sign magnitude form representation, only the MSB has to be taken into sign bit, remaining all has to be taken magnitude bit. Rahul Kumar is asking, sir, please explain why the rule for any base number system is not applicable for string number system. Please explain why the rule for any base number is not applicable. There is a call. Hello? Hello? Yes? Voice is, hello? Tell me.
Four zero nine six, 64, 8 and 6, right? Yes. Can't we directly write 4096 is 2 power 12 and 64 is 2 power 6 and then proceed?
For the first problem, huh?
Yeah, sorry.
You mute your volume.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Let me take down that.
Okay.
Can you please detect me? What is that?
So, the first problem, we have written in power of 8 and then converted it to binary form, right? So, why can't we directly write in binary form in powers of 2 and then do it directly? Instead of going to 8 and then to 2, why can't we directly do write it in powers of 2?
Then, is it possible to get directly the base 2 representation of that?
Yeah, so we can represent 4096 as 2 power 12, 64 is 2 power 6, 8 is 2 cube, and for 6 it is 1, so this is 2 power 0. So we can write now.
Okay, you are saying that 2 power, the sequence is 2 power 12, then 2 power 6, 3 like that, huh? If you are feeling comfortable, it's okay. Because, see, that is, it is, for everyone, it is easily interpretable that that polynomial is directly given in base 8 form. If you are going one step ahead, that's okay. It's good, you can do that.
No, sir, my only question is, will we get the same answer?
Why not? Yes. Yes.
We will.
One step you are compressing there. I am expanding one step. Conclusion will be same. You can verify. No problem.
Okay.
I understood. Like you are saying what?
But I don't seem to get the answer, sir. I am not getting the answer. It will not be same.
You check the calculation things. It should come same.
Yeah, I check the calculation. If I directly go for base of 2, then I'm getting the answer is 4 only.
Can you tell me the polynomial? Please tell me the polynomial.
The polynomial, you want me to tell the question?
Yeah, yeah. 4096
into? Into 7 plus 64 into 3. 4096 into 7 plus 64 into 3 plus 5 into 8 plus 6.
Okay. Tell me what you are saying. 2 power 12.
Yeah. 4096 is 2 power 12.
Okay.
64 is 2 power 6. 8 is 2 cube. And obviously 1 is 2 power 0.
Okay, what you are saying here? What you are doing now?
What? After this, So wherever I have pulse of 2 where it has a value, I will write it as 1 and the rest of all places will be 0.
One second, please repeat.
No, sir, wherever we have power of 2, that is 2 power 12, 7, it exists. So in that place, we are writing 1. And wherever 2, I mean, we have a coefficient 0, we have 0. So,
is it, do you know what you are doing here? See, one thing, listen here. Suppose, okay, you are saying this, then definitely you will not get the answer. See, suppose a number is 3756 is there. Okay.
Okay.
So this is 3 into 1000 plus 7 into 100 plus 5 into 10 plus 6. But the common point to observe, 10 cube, 10 square, 10 power 1, 10 power 0. It's in a sequential way. That's why I am representing this 3756. If a power is missing, I have to introduce. But do you think between 12 to 6, is it continuous?
If, if the power is missing, then we can write it as 2, then the next time after this we can write 2 power 11 into 0 plus 2 power 10 into 0, like that we can write, no?
Okay. Then what you are saying, then we should write this as? What is the answer we should write then?
Then, I'm getting the answer as 4.
No, you tell me then what I should write, in the next step then? Do you think I should write 7, 3, what I should write?
First is 2 power 12 into 7, the next one will be 2 power 11 into 0.
But how do you write the binary of that then? I understood what you are saying. We expanded the polynomial. Then how do you represent the binary of this?
Then if I write the binary, so the 13th digit that will be 1. Then
how?
The next 12 digit will be 0.
Here you are missing. Here the mistake is happening in this step.
Okay.
You think it here. It is not actually not correct. How can you say directly from here? See, you tally the step what I did. Hello. Here you are missing the point, some point.
So, I don't understand, sir. After this, I don't know how I'm wrong, actually.
Actually, the thing is, unnecessarily, you are making the situation complication here, at this step.
Okay.
Actually, here it is, after expanding the polynomial in two-power form, the way we are saying we'll replace that is not correct. You try to analyze this.
So I understood. It shouldn't be 7, 3, 5 and 1. It should only be either 1 or 0.
Yeah, you tell me one thing. Is it possible that in base 2 form I can have a digit 7356?
It is not possible. Yes, sir, I understood now.
Is it possible in base 2 I can have 7356? Impossible. So yeah, here itself the mistake is happening.
Okay. We have to look at the digit before choosing the base.
Of course. Okay. See. Actually, when you ask first time, I interpret some different way. I will solve, that is the most optimum way I solve that. So that has to be answered. Because in this case, what you are saying, you cannot take the digit directly because in binary form, we can have only 0 and combination, where the question of 7-3 comes into picture. Not possible.
Okay.
Hello?
That's it. Thank you. Hello?
Are you getting or not?
Yes, sir. I'm okay now. I'm clear now. Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine. And then Saurabh is asking, sir, once please explain why 0 have unique representation in 2s complement form. Already explained very clearly. You refer the video on demand. And then Avinash is asking, sir, please explain once more plus 0 minus 0 are same in 2s complement. I don't know why again you are having doubt on this. If you remember, how I represented plus 5 and minus 5, right, in a similar way, to represent minus 5, what I did, I represented plus 5, that is 0, 1, 0, 1. To represent minus 5, I have taken the 2s complement of this, which is 1, 1, 0, 1. So to represent plus 0, so this is 0, 0, 0, 0. To represent minus 0, I have to again take 2s complement of this. So what I am getting here? 0, 0, 0, 0. That means plus 0, minus 0 coding into S complement form is same. They are resulting the same number. It is not correct in 1S and 2S. Right? I hope this is clear. So, we will continue next session. So, we practice this problem. There are some problems are pending and some more important observations are there. We will continue the class in next session.